The Transportation Department is unfazed by the looming transport strike. Our correspondent Andrea Taguines is now on the line for more on the government's reaction. Go ahead, Andy.
Hi, Denise. The Department of Transportation again shrugged off threats of another transport strike by groups that are against the government's public transport modernization program. This after Manibela earlier said that they would be conducting another transport strike this coming June 10 to 12. DOTR Undersecretary for the Road Sector, Andy Ortega, said government agencies are already used to such kinds of protest action, so they already know what to do and which areas they would most likely need to deploy free rides to or alternative modes of transportation for commuters. He also pointed out that even after the consolidation deadline last April 30, even if many jeepney drivers were not able to comply, there continues to be a sufficient number of public utility vehicles catering to the riding public. Still, he said the DOTR will also find more ways to help unconsolidated jeepney operators. For instance, LTFRB board member Mercy Lanes said they will be meeting soon to talk about possibly giving unconsolidated jeepney operators a provisional authority to keep operating for at least a year, as proposed by a lawmaker during the last hearing by the House Committee on Transportation. The LTFRB has also yet to start apprehending Kalorum jeepneys until they've completed the due process of revoking their franchises. Meanwhile, the DOTR and San Miguel Corporation, the private sector proponent of the MRT-7, are set to conduct a joint site inspection of the possible route realignments proposed by the local government of San Jose del Monte in Bulacan this month. That's according to DOTR Assistant Secretary for Railways, Georgette Aquino. Aquino said the local government unit, where the 14th station of the MRT-7 project will be located, presented three alternative route alignments to DOTR because it said the current plan would have immediate and future traffic implications that would affect the quality of living in the area as well as the delivery of essential services. According to Aquino, after the inspection, San Miguel will be tasked to draft a new feasibility and ridership study and recommend the best way forward. Because of these adjustments, Aquino said they expect the completion and operation of the San Jose del Monte MRT-7 station to be pushed back to 2027. But she noted that the first 12 stations of the project from North Avenue to Quirino Avenue will be fully operational by end of 2025, while the 13th station will be ready by the end of 2026. The DOTR initially targeted to have the whole train line running as early as this year, but right-of-way issues led to several delays.
Isa dito sa mga tinitingnan natin is not only yung location na in terms of mas konti ba ang tatamaan na right of way. Siyempre, tinitingnan natin yung convenience ng pasahero. Malapit ba ito sa mga transport terminals, no, para mas madaling mapuntahan ng ating mga pasahero. Kung makapag-decide na tayo, no, for the location of San Jose del Monte, hopefully by 2027, yes, makakapag-operate yung Station 14.
Denise, the MRT-7 project is a 22-kilometer railway with 14 stations, which will run from North Avenue in Quezon City to San Jose del Monte City in Bulacan. It is expected to cater to approximately 530,000 passengers daily. Back to you, Denise.
Andrea Taguines with that story. Thanks, Andy. Rizal Commercial Banking Corporation's push for a seamless digital banking experience continues to bear fruit. RCBC President and CEO Eugene Acevedo revealed 9 out of every 10 transactions in the bank is already digital, and more than 50% of borrowings come from their mobile application. Acevedo adds they will continue to consider using artificial intelligence, data-driven campaigns, and robotic process automation to give their customers a better digital banking experience.
90% of our transactions are already digital. The rest is manual. Wow. More than half of our loans are now originated, personal loans are now originated using our mobile app. Wow. But what you cannot see is that in the middle office, where people tend to not associate this with digitization, we've put in significant effort in AI, in data science, and in robotic process automation to make sure that everybody becomes much more productive.
Here's the World Bank keep its 5.8% growth projection for the Philippines this year. This remains lower than the government's target range of 6 to 7% for 2024. World Bank officials in a Tuesday briefing warned of slower domestic demand as high inflation persists amid extreme weather events. It also sees weaker demand should the central bank's borrowing rates stay higher for longer. Still, the World Bank says domestic demand and recovery of global trade continue to keep the growth outlook positive. It also urged the government to ramp up spending on infrastructure to attract more investments.